Hello and welcome to Hank Games Without a Hank. We are the Swindon Swoodilypoopers. It is raining in England, although somehow it seems the sun is also shining, which is sort of miraculous. We are the Swindon Swoodilypoopers, as I just said. We've got one size fits all in the back. We got Perry. We got other John Green and Ball John Green. Our side is unchanged from last game because I was so proud of how we performed, except for Fat Lucas. But, you know, Fat Lucas is going through a tough time and we're sticking with him because you insist that I do. I appreciate that you guys believe in loyalty. That has, to be fair, that has been the Swoodilypoopers mantra from the very beginning of our improbable rise toward the Premier League. So, you know, if we gotta stick with what works, I guess. And what works so far is loyalty. But oh, Fat Lucas is just—he's not looking 100% to me. Today, I'm going to talk about my favorite teachers. I had a lot of great teachers, so it's hard to pick favorites. I was very, very lucky to have a really good education, and a lot of having a good education is about having the right teachers at the right time in your life. But I should add that I was not a good student in high school. I think I graduated with a GPA that was under 3.0, and I was not an attentive student, and I was not a pleasant guy to have in class at all. I was kind of a douche, to be honest with you. And a lot of that came from me wanting attention. A lot of it came from me being lazy and procrastinating. And, you know, some people are fun to have in class and some people aren't. And I was one of the ones who wasn't. Oh, other John Green with a great goal. Just raw strength. And then other John Green, the star of this year's NPower Championship, scores in the 13th minute to put Swindon Town up 1-0. And we are going to beat the crap out of Derby County. Derby County? I don't know. They say things weird in England. You know, if you wanted me to say everything right, you shouldn't have hired an American manager, Swoodilypoopers. Uh-oh, Ball John Green with a breakaway. Oh, Ball John Green. I love the way he runs, but he can't finish. Oh, I tell you what, pre-injury, Ball John Green puts that in the net 10 times out of 10. And then we have an unnecessary slide tackle and frustration. One size fits all with a great tackle because he is one size fits all. One of the greatest players in the history of the Swoodilypoopers. I would say, I say that to preface the fact that one of my favorite teachers of all time, Mr. McAdam, basically failed me. He taught my junior English class. And he gave me an incomplete because I did not attend class often enough. And then when I finished, so I had to like write some papers over the summer in order to pass the class. And I did write those papers. I wrote them, I remember, on the Toni Morrison's The Bluest Eye and the Shakespeare play Twelfth Night. And I passed the class with a D. And that was my junior year of English literature, which of course is now one of my passions. And I got a D. And yet in all of that time, Mr. McAdam was insistent that I was going to be a good student. And that I was going to succeed, if not in his class, then at least in life. And that's what made him such an extraordinary teacher. Also, he was really good at teaching literature. I had several really good English teachers in high school, but the two that that come to mind are Diane Martin and Mr. McAdam. Diane much more... was much more helpful to me in terms of teaching me how to read critically. I remember I took a class in Faulkner and other Southern writers, and she was very, very helpful. Oh, off the post! Oh, Ball John Green puts that away 10 times out of 10 before his injury. Now he hits it right off the post. She was really helpful to me in terms of like learning how to read read critically when I read the books that she assigned, which unfortunately wasn't always. And so that was really important to me. But what was so amazing to me about Mr. McAdam was that I was a terrible, terrible student. I was desperately trying to fail. And he refused to accept that, which I think is kind of a sign of the best teachers. They have to have this sort of superhuman patience about them and a belief in their students, even when there is absolutely no evidence. Oh, Ball John Green. Bald John Green with a great goal in the 45th minute. And look at the celebrations. Other John Green's tracking him down. Oh, he's excited. So there's a... there's a relentlessness in great teachers. And that must be very hard, because you have to be relentless about a lot of students every year, over and over and over again. These kids who don't give you much back necessarily, you have to believe in them. And that's really hard. But that's what Mr. McAdam was so great at. Even when I gave him no evidence that I would ever be anything other than a massive failure, he just refused to accept it. He was also sort of my creative writing advisor, and he was an early and extremely supportive fan of my writing. And I remember my mom had a conversation with him in which she said, is it realistic that John could be a writer? You know, basically asking, should I dissuade him from wanting to do this? Like, should I, you know, or should we let him go to college, you know, and study, of all things, English? And Mr. McAdam said yes. He said, yeah, I think John, oh no, oh, Fat Lucas, I apologize for everything naughty I have ever said about you. You are having a great game today. Congratulations, Fat Lucas. You're ahead, appears to be back in the game. So, oh, ball John Green, scores from other John Green. And look, just, what? He was not off, no! Oh. By the way, ball John Green lately looks like a zombie when they do a close-up on his eyes. Can someone get a screen cap of that so we can examine his state of living and or undeadness? That ended up making a huge difference in my career. It gave me confidence as a writer, but also it gave my parents confidence in me as a writer. It was a class thing of him to do. He's generally a pretty class act to me. And I, of course, never treated him with anything other than, you know, total disrespect. Because I was, you know, one of those students. But it wasn't just in English. I also had great teachers in math. I had a great geometry and pre-calc teacher, Mr. Lantrip. I had great teachers in history. In fact, so some of you know, or hopefully all of you know, that I am doing a new channel with Hank called Crash Course, which is going to be Fat Lucas. Thank you, Fat Lucas, having the game of his season. Which is going to be basically, we're going to be trying to teach in a series of like 9 to 11 minute videos subjects. Hank's going to teach a sort of intro to biology, and I'm going to teach world history, college level, hopefully like college level or AP level world history class. That was a nice move there. So we're doing that. And the writer for my, the person who's writing essentially the curriculum for the history class, the one that I'm doing, is my high school history teacher, Raul Meyer. We went back and forth and we interviewed all these like professors and history teachers and everything. And then I was like, why don't we just call Raul and see if he can do it? He's now like a super fancy teacher / lawyer. He's like one of those people who can do anything. But when he was my high school history teacher, he was like a 23-year-old recent graduate of Brown, who'd ended up at this boarding school in Alabama. And he was just a great teacher. And I mean, you could tell from the beginning, like, he was another guy who just, like, I showed absolutely no promise and I was nothing but annoying, and he just never gave up on me, which I'm really grateful for. Hopefully I can pay him back a little bit with this, by making him our teacher for history. But I will share you something that Raul said to me once. I smoked cigarettes in high school, and it really pissed him off. He really didn't like it. He felt like it, and it was in some ways, he felt like it was a symbol of my inability to, like, be mature about everything. My inability to be mature about my body, my inability to be mature about my, what a great goal from ball John Green. Other John Green to ball John Green. Great cross, great goal, and then that hug with a lot of stuff between the knees, just belly to belly, chest to chest, a lot of contact. And it's raining, you know, so they're just wet, just covered in, yeah, it's great stuff. Great celebration. Sorry, I'm trying to inspire better slash fiction. I can't even remember what I was talking about. All right, so I smoked cigarettes, and I, you know, he felt like it was just a, a symbol of my inability to be like mature and rational and to basically to live up to my potential. And he once said to me, he got really annoyed one time because it was I was like, I haven't been smoking, and I reeked of cigarette smoke, and I was clearly lying. And just, he was like, you know what, John, I hope that you keep smoking. I hope that you keep smoking and that you die one day after you stop paying into Social Security so that you can be someone who helps pay for my Social Security without ever taking out a dime of your own. And I was like, that really left an impression on me. And I, you know, and just 5 short years later, I quit smoking. Goals today from John Green, John Green, and John Green. We win 3-0 thanks to a clean sheet from Fat Lucas. Everybody's happy. And, of course, our opponents are kneeling in shame and smelling their armpits. Congratulations to all the boys today. There's, oh, look at that mustache. Love it. Thanks for watching. Best wishes.